Hello everyone, myself Malike Krishna. Today I want to teach to you combination reaction. Combination reaction. First of all, we have to see here some example of combination reaction. First example is that reaction between ammonia and HCl. For that, first of all, you have to take the test tube. This is the test tube which containing small amount of HCl. This is the HCl. Then you heat this test tube by using burner. In this way you have to heat this. What happened? Some vapors of HCl will be emanating from this liquid HCl. Then you take the glass rod. This is the glass rod, and you put this glass rod on the top of the test tube. And this glass rod is already dipped in ammonia solution. So I can say that this is the glass rod of ammonia solution. Okay, this is the glass rod of ammonia solution. You take that and you put that glass rod on the top of the test tube. Similarly, this glass rod is already dipped in ammonia, so some gaseous molecules of ammonia will be here. I mean, it is sticked on the glass rod. Okay, then what happened? The gas of HCl, which is emanating from the liquid HCl, and it will combines to gas of the ammonia. You see here what is the actual reaction between them. Okay, here is a NH3, which is in what? Gaseous form. This NH3 from glass rod. Okay, glass rod, and this ammonia is reacted to HCl from the vapors of HCl. Here is a HCl which is in gaseous, and when they combines to each other to produce here NH3 instead of that NH4. Okay, not NH3. Why not NH3? Because here a reaction is takes place. Okay, then NH3 and this hydrogen, that is the NH4, and here is a Cl, that is the ammonium chloride. Okay, ammonium chloride. And firstly, it is in a gaseous form. Okay, after condensation process it goes into solid form. Okay, in this way we get ammonium chloride by ammonia and HCl. That means when gaseous ammonia and gaseous HCl, gaseous form of ammonia and gaseous form of HCl, when combines to each other to produce ammonium chloride, firstly in gaseous form, after condensation process each goes in solid form. In this way, by combining ammonia and HCl, we get only one product. So this is the reaction of combination reaction. Okay, in this way we get only one product. Okay, this is one of the example of reaction, combination reaction. Then second example is that here is a second example. Second example is that reaction between reaction between magnesium and oxygen. Okay, you have to first of all take magnesium strip. Okay, you take the magnesium strip and then it ignite, then I mean it is ignited with the help of oxygen to produce 2MgO. What happens generally in this reaction, this magnesium is combined with this oxygen molecule to produce magnesium oxide. In this reaction, this magnesium strip is held by pair of tongue and it is ignited. Then on heating with air to produce magnesium oxide. So it is the reaction of combination. Okay, combination. Why combination? Because magnesium and oxygen, these two reactants react to each other to produce magnesium oxide. So we get here only one product. And such type of reaction is known as combination reaction. Okay, then third example is that you take the beaker. Okay, this is the beaker. This is the beaker which containing water. Okay, small amount of water, and you add the slaked lime, that is the what? CaO. You add this slaked lime into this beaker, and already beaker containing what? H2O. Then reaction is takes place in this way, CaO plus H2O, okay, to produce Ca in bracket OH twice, that is the calcium hydroxide. That means calcium hydroxide is produced by combination of calcium oxide and water. Here is a calcium in reactant Ca is 1, in product is here is 1. How much oxygen is in reactant? Here is 1, here is 1, that means 2. Here is a 2 oxygen, and how much hydrogen in reactant? 2, and in product here is also 2. That means reaction is balanced. Okay, reaction is balanced. In this way we get calcium hydroxide is only one product by using calcium oxide and water. So it is one of the example of combination reaction. Why? Because two reactant react to each other and we get only one product. Okay, so it is the combination of reaction. Then how we can define the combination reaction? When two reactant react to each other, okay, these two reactant react to each other to produce only one product, such as magnesium oxide. Such a reaction is known as combination reaction. Similarly, we can say that when two reactant is react to each other to produce only one product, this product, then such type of reaction is known as combination reaction. We can say that shortly, when two reactant react to each other to produce only one product, then such type of reaction is known as combination reaction. Then tell me, in three reaction, first of all, already we have seen one example of reaction, that is the ammonia is reacted with HCl to produce NH4Cl. Okay, NH4Cl. Then this is the first reaction of combination, then this is the second, then third, then in first reaction, how much reactant is taken here? 2. What about product? Product is 1. Similarly, in second reaction, how much reactant is taken here? 2. And what about product? 1. Okay. Then in third reaction, how much reactant is taken? 2. Here is a 2. And how much product is produced? Here is 1. Okay, by observing these three reactions, we can say that when two reactants react to each other to produce only one product, then it is known as combination reaction. Similarly, here two molecule is taken, ammonia and HCl. Here is magnesium, but not molecules, okay? Oxygen is molecule, and here is two molecules which is combines to each other to produce calcium hydroxide. In this way we can understand what is the concept of a combination reaction. Okay, I think you will understand very well. Okay, we will stop here. Okay.